Do you want to risk your bank account being hacked, your private details taken to get your password, or your computer servers being held for ransom? No? Then you need to watch this video to make sure you can spot and avoid phishing emails. In 2019, it is estimated that over 4.7 billion phishing emails are sent every day. The email or text is a lure, and then they reel you in. You may receive emails from a source that seems like a legitimate business, government, bank, or internet provider. I've seen them from PayPal, Apple, Facebook, banks, tax office, my phone provider, my courier, the list goes on. The scammer is asking you to verify your details, your credit card information, ask for a donation, or for you to renew your password. And this is all to try to get your information for some sort of identity or money theft. Typically, they will try some fear strategy, alerting you to suspicious activity on your account, or closing down one of your accounts. It will generally have a sense of urgency to it. You must do it in the next 24 hours. If not, your account will be cancelled immediately. The problem is that they look so real with branding, logos, and similar websites or domain names. I'm going to show you some of the tells to help you spot them. Let's look at some examples. Firstly, the question you need to ask yourself is, were you expecting this email? I got some emails that my credit card details needed to be updated, but I had a credit card replaced. So I was expecting these emails. But if my card hadn't been replaced, I would have known straight away. But even so, I was cautious. So I continue checking. I suppose the tip is to be really careful if you don't know the people or organization and don't click on anything till you are sure. They may not address you by your correct name or may not address you personally. If this is something to do with your account closing, then they should know your name. Or you might notice it's sent to a list rather than to just your email. They might have typing errors or mistakes in the grammar. This used to be an easy tell, but current phishing messages do appear more genuine these days. And in real emails, sometimes people make mistakes, but it is another warning sign. Don't just check the name of the person sending you the email. Check their email address by hovering over it with your mouse or clicking on it with your phone, which should show their details. You would expect it to be coming from the company's domain. Scammers do have other ways of hiding their real address, so once again, don't take it as real because it has the company domain. Keep checking. Before you click on any link, hover over that link to see the actual web address, not just the text it displays. Make sure you don't click it. Now, you can't do this as easily on a mobile, so either you wait and look at the email on your desktop, or if you're confident on doing a hard press on the mobile, where you hold it until it comes up with the pop-up window asking you if you want to open it in another tab, which we would cancel out of, but that pop-up shows the real link. Only do this if you are confident at doing hard presses. Now, you're looking for the link to not be the company's normal website. Sometimes it'll be obvious. Sometimes it will be a spelling issue, just one letter changed around, or numbers added after it. However, sometimes they will get quite clever. I've seen them where they've done a domain address lie, so it appears like it is really taking me to the Commonwealth Bank page and then to a subpage called Fix Login. But actually, it's the other way around. This is taking me to the Fix Login site and to a subpage called Commonwealth Bank. Also check for the secure symbols, https://, at the start. Legitimate websites that ask you to enter confidential information should be an encrypted site with the https. Go and search the internet with the subject line in the email or the exact wording of the email to check for any references to a scam. The Snopes.com site exposes a lot of these scam emails. In Australia, we also have the www.scamwatch.gov.au site and the www.staysmartonline.gov.au/alert-service site. But the best way to be sure is one method where I'm extremely proud of my mum. It's probably from years of me drilling it into her head, but the other week she received a phishing email that appeared to come from her phone provider asking her to check her details. The first thing she did was phone that company, to check if they'd sent it. They hadn't and were aware of the scam, and so she deleted the email. So remember, you can pick up the phone and contact the person or business that sent the message. But be careful that you don't use the information listed in the email or reply to the email, but instead go onto the real company's website and get the contact information from there. If they did send an attachment or link, it would be a good idea to ask them to describe it so you can double check it is what you have received, as there have been instances where scammers have intercepted emails from companies and replaced with their own scam email. Yep, I'm sounding paranoid, but you do need to be careful. Even more worrying is what they call spear phishing. These messages target specific people and organizations and may contain information that is true to make them appear more authentic. The criminals will research and use information from a company or about you that they'll get from social media to appear more authentic. That is just another reason not to comment on those scam Facebook posts asking you to name a dog with no E in the name, as people usually think of their own dog's names. And it is these type of posts that help them to gather information about you. The worst scammer emails that I've seen have a document attached, and sometimes they're very clever and do it around event timings. I've seen ones around tax time pretending to be from the tax department with your refund attached. Of course it wasn't, it was an infected document. These are much more scary because the documents or PDFs, MP4s or zip files can contain malware, which stands for malicious software, which installs that software on your computer, and that is where they can track what you're doing or lock off your computer, and ransomware demand payments would be needed to unlock your computer. 92% of malware is delivered via email these days. So don't open an attachment unless you are really sure. I know they are tempting to open that video file with the funny dogs, but once again, you really need to double check with the person sending it to make sure that it is a safe file. And to be extra safe, I suggest that you disable your macros in Microsoft Office. Some of these emails have a link that brings up a pop-up window asking you to log in. Don't do it. One version of a computer worm pretended to be from PayPal, and people gave over their login details. There is a current one going around with malware coming through the phishing email called Emotet, and it comes through with an attachment. This is an example of what it might look like, but it does come in all sorts of emails. So be careful. And now they're sending them through as texts as well, so you have to watch out there too. Now you've identified it as a scam, what should you do? The easiest way is to delete the email, not just to trash. You need to either shift key and delete, or delete it and then go into your trash and delete it again for good. What if you opened it and sent your details through? Then immediately get onto the correct company and stop your credit card or change your password details. If you opened a possible malware file, then I suggest that you turn your computer off and take it to a computer consultant skilled on cleaning your computer. Sometimes nothing might happen immediately, but you might have clicked on one and you might see new icons on your screen, or you might find that computer is not running as fast as it used to be, and that could be because it might be quietly stealing your information over time. It's not the only reason for computers going slow, but it could be the case. Of course, it always helps if you keep your virus protection on your computer up to date, with patches automatically downloading. If you don't have a virus protection software installed, then I've added a link in the description below. And then in Australia, we can send the phishing emails off to the ACCC at www.scamwatch.gov.au/report-a-scam. In the US, you can forward them to the FTC at spam@uce.gov and to the anti-phishing working group at reportphishing@apwg.org. And in the US, if you believe your identity has been stolen, report it at www.identitytheft.gov. You need to understand that your financial institution and other large organizations such as Amazon, PayPal, Google, Apple, Facebook, and others would never send you a link and ask you to enter your personal or financial details. Remember that the most important thing is not to click on any links or attachments unless you are sure, and contact the person sending it to you. Always stay vigilant.
Thanks for watching the video. Please like or share it and subscribe to make sure you get future tips.